Uganda is largely a peaceful country with some cases of violence threatening the security situation. We sit down with Colonel Deo Akiki, the deputy spokesperson of the UPDF, to talk to us about the security situation and the ADF activities in the country and the Operation Shujaa in Democratic Republic of Congo. Our commander-in-chief is known as Esa Balwanyi in the region, in Africa and the entire world. Why has the ADF continued to antagonize Ugandans?
ADF has been around for quite some time, but with safe havens in the DRC where they have been for over 20 years. Because of some other challenges, we were not able to deal with ADF totally, because we were not allowed to cross into the Congo. Thank God, the regime of His Excellency Etienne Tshisekedi reached an agreement with the leadership in Uganda and among the leadership between FADC, the Congo Army, and UPDF, and we were able to be given the opportunity to fight alongside, jointly with the Congolese forces, to make sure that we bring this menace of ADF to the end.
8,000 people fled their homes in Toroko district, and some of them have not returned. What security guarantee do you give to those people and Ugandans at large about the security situation in the country?
Yes, first of all, those who came in because of that incursion, when we engaged the ADF, the next 2 days, majority of them had returned into their homes. There could be a few elements who still have fear, but the message is that ADF can no longer cause havoc along that time. Even when ADF came, suddenly two people, information we got about the two people who were killed, which we did not verify whether it was ADF, and the one who was injured, yes, it was verified. I think it was the crossfire. So the capability of UPDF to deter ADF from causing any mayhem is real, and we have proved this. Our message to the people of Ntoroko and any other area is to settle down. UPDF has the capacity to deal with any threat that can come into the country. And this, we have done it with precision, and it speaks for itself. For the rest of the country, I would say, yes, we are called an island of peace within an area of geographical instability, I would say. Our geography in terms of security ways has not been good because of especially countries like DRC, South Sudan, which have not been stable. We are bound to keep putting security as our priority because of these neighbors who are not stable. And thank God now the East African community has put up a force to jointly try as much as possible to get rid of all rebel activities in Eastern Congo. In security terms, I would say the year 2022 has been generally calm, and the country has been peaceful. Compared to the year 2020, 2021, when we had all these kinds of skirmishes because of our type of politicking and electioneering, to us, we can measure security of a country depending on the threats and how did these threats try to implement their agenda. Security threat number one has been always ADF. And by going to Congo, we are able to dismantle the agenda of ADF, despite attempts of trying to prove otherwise. The sabotage acts, criminal acts of trying to grab guns by some elements of ADF and criminals, because this is something that must come clear, that the time, the short time, as you can see now, it's no longer there, it's already destroyed. When guns were being picked from police and attempts to get from ADF, a case in Nakaseke, those who tried were all killed, and even the gun they came with was removed, elements of ADF. The same with some elements in Masaka. In Jinja, Gaddafi, it was an element of criminality. Some ex-soldiers, some desert actually, who tried also to get guns from colleagues. He was later got, and the two guns recovered, and the person involved himself killed and a colleague arrested. So to us, these are normal security issue challenges that we deal with on a daily basis. And it is part of our job to make sure that any attempt to destabilize or to cause insecurity in the country is dealt with decisively.
According to Kano here, the Operation Shujaa is down at the source of the problem of the ADF. We should expect Uganda to be more peaceful this year, 2023. Thank you.